Hello, Internet, and welcome back to another installment of How to Create. Today, I am Old Man Shorty. I'll be your host, and we are going to look at the mechanical mixer. Yes, we're going to need this. We're going to need this to proceed on. I didn't want to cover this topic quite so soon because of the complexity that gets involved in this. As you can see, I've already got this set up right here. We're gonna break it down a little easier for you. But it is required. It is required because what we have to do is make this stuff here called brass. And we need brass. All right, brass is gonna be important to progress in the mod. We have to be able to get beyond andesite things. And so the mixer recipe is really easy. To make the mixer, all you need is a cog, andesite casing, and a whisk. We don't know how to make the whisk yet, but remember the last time I showed you how to make the plating, the iron plates. So two andesite and iron plates makes our whisk really easy. Then we can put together our mixer. We got that made. There is another item you will need for this, the basin, which is really easy to make. Just five andesite casing makes your basin. You will need that. Think of this as a big giant mixer, mixing pot, something of that nature. You're gonna mix metals together. You're gonna mix different things together. There's a lot of uses for this thing. We're not gonna be covering them all. We're gonna be covering very few of them actually. But in order to make this thing work, to do what we wanna do today, we are gonna have to have a item called a blaze burner. That's what I have in my hand right here. That's what it looks like. That's like the big heater that's going to be cooking all this stuff together and making it work. We're going to be making a blaze burner. I know you guys know how to get to the nether, right? I mean, you guys know how to do that. I mean, everybody knows how to do that. So we have to make the empty blaze burner, which is really pretty simple. We're just taking a piece of netherrack, surrounding it with iron, not surrounding it, but putting one on each side of iron sheets. And that's going to give us an empty blaze burner, right? That by itself is not going to do us a bit of good because we have to have a heat source in there. The heat source we have to have is a blaze. So we have to basically capture a blaze in this empty blaze burner, which you will be going to the nether. I am going to cheat one in like that. As soon as you cheat it in, you right-click it with the burner. Right-click it with the burner, sir. There we go. Right click it with the burner and it will give you a blaze burner. It puts him in there. That guy's ready to go. Now in order to use this guy, we can use coal or charcoal or wood or anything that burns that you can put into a furnace. We'll go inside this thing. You see he glows. He'll glow for a little while until he burns up all the fuel and then it won't glow anymore. And that will heat the pot. It's going to be vitally important that we know that early on. All right, so what we want to do is we're going to need a water wheel again to power this, and I'll show you how setting this thing up works. We're going to use the same deal I did before, except I'm going to hide this one in the ground a little better. Yeah, we're going to just dig a 2-deep hole here like so. All right, and then we're going to take us our water wheel. We're going to step out on our little porch here and put it on there. We're going to step out here and we can see that, the way that's made, it scoops the water up. So we got to put the water right there, like so. And that's going to hide it in the ground. Then what I can do is take grass or any block or whatever I want, kind of cover this thing over. And it's hidden, right? It's hidden. It's out of sight, out of mind. I will need a shaft, of course, to extend it to get it up here above the ground. Right there, got it. All right, so next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna need the basin. Where did the basin go? Actually, we need the burner. I'm sorry, I told you wrong. We need the burnerator. All right, and on top of the burner, we're gonna set the basin we made. Shift click, perfect. There we go. And then on top of that, we're gonna need our mixer. If I have one in my inventory, I do have one in my inventory, as a matter of fact. So we're gonna need to set that on top of that. There it is, right there. And then we can gear up to this thing. And I've done this a certain way on purpose, except I need, there, I've got them right there, okay. We're gonna shaft this on up a little higher. One more. And then we're gonna put a gear on top of that, like that. And I'll put another gear beside it. So that turns it. There we go. We got it right. Everything's good. Everything's good, except we look at it and go, uh-oh, it's not fast enough. The mechanical mixers require a little more speed. And I did all this way on purpose because I'm going to take this down now. And on top of this shaft, I'm going to put a big cog. We're going to speed this thing up. Remember how we did this, right? I showed you guys how to do this. We're probably going to have to move this over a little bit. Probably going to have to move it over a little bit, but we can go out this way and put another little cog outside here, which is going to double the speed of this thing, right? In the corner. And then we can go up with a shaft. Actually, if we wanted to, we could probably speed this up again. I don't know if you want to, but we could. We could speed it up again. And we'll put another cog in there. Perfect. And then we'll just shaft that up a little bit. Right up here. Boom. We'll need a cog on top of that gear. There. Perfect. Got it. All right. So now it's spinning. And if we look at it, it shows it's spinning fast enough, right? I am going to temporarily just put a block here so I can jump up here and show you the things and everything. All right, so what we need to do, what we're trying to make here is this brass. And if I look in JEI, which you will have JEI, and there's many ways to do this in the mod packs. There's other mods like Tinker's Construct, Immersive Engineering, and other things, other ways to make this. But if we look at the brass and we go over here to the mixing tab, you can see this can require one copper, one zinc, gives us two of those, but it has to be on a heated burner. So what I'm going to do, and you can load these up, by the way, I am going to put some this in here. And I'm going to put several of them in because I'm going to be talking. It's going to slow down, but that'll hold it. It's like a furnace. You can put up, I think, 8 in there. So what we're going to need is a copper ingot, and we're going to need a zinc ingot. Let me get some stuff here. Copper to zinc ingot. And we're just going to throw that in there. Boom. Copper, zinc. And then when we do, and when it's got the right ingredients, it'll just start churning away. And when it's done, it'll stop the animation. Boom. There you go. We have easy as butter. We got brass ingots. That is all you need to know about the mechanical mixer. And this thing does other stuff too. You can put liquids in here. You can mix all kind of crazy things. And we'll get to some of that stuff later. Now, I have used a water wheel setup, and something that I hadn't showed you guys before, but if you need to change the orientation, like these shafts are horizontal, this requires a vertical. You can actually take two of the larger gears and tie them together to change the orientation on that. Works really quite well. So basically what I've done is use this belt to power everything. This belt back here merely transfers the power to that belt over down there and this belt up here. With the same setup I showed you over there with a mechanical mixer, we're going to use chest andesite funnels to feed the belts out. We've put the andesite funnels on the sides of this basin, which is going to cause it to pull the stuff in for us automatically. So, I mean, I can throw this on the belt, obviously, and it'll feed it in, and there goes our copper. And then if I go over here and I throw in our brass... If I have a piece of brass, zinc, I'm sorry, brass, I said zinc. And we throw that on this belt, it'll feed in here. We can put it in the same belt. And it should have started me. Oh, the burner's not hot. That's right. There's no burner action going on here. So we must drop a coal on there, and then it'll start mixing. Now, whenever you have an output on a belt here on this mixer, it automatically forms an output chute. So the product will go out. Now, the way I've got this set up here now is I can automate this by merely putting my zinc in one side and putting, okay, that wasn't what I wanted to do. Copper. I can put my copper in the other side. Right there. And this will feed in on these belts, except, and the reason I had this block here is to stop this when it gets full. The block will keep this from going any farther. And it'll just keep spitting out brass. So that is a full automation. Really, really simple. And that's going to allow us to get brass. Because the next thing we're going to do is use some of this brass to make some more advanced things in this mod. I realize this is a pretty crazy setup. Take you a picture of this. Look around. This is how you automate this process. And it works great. It works great. You're going to use this. You're going to use this. If you use this mod, you're going to need this brass. The brass is highly important. Yeah, we got lots of it. And it just cranks it out. Now, of course, till the burner runs out of fuel. And then you just go over here and throw some more fuel on it. And it keeps going. There is a way to automatically feed this burner. And I'll show you how to do that. Now that we have brass, this is going to open up a lot of worlds to us right here. It's going to open up a lot of worlds to a lot of different things, and we'll go from there. But yes, that's the simple manual version. You can jump up here and throw the ingredients in, and it'll make for you. Just have to keep the burner going and keep throwing coal on it. And there you go. That's a simple manual way to start it. Here's a little more complex automated way to doing it, and it works really quite well. And to automate it, and then all you gotta do is throw your ingredients in. We could throw them all in one chest, but the problem is this basin only holds so many pieces, and if you don't mix it, do it just right, you'll wind up filling it up with one or the other, and then it'll stop altogether. All right, and it should be running about out by now. I don't know if it is. Okay, it must be close. And there you go. And see, that would automate, and you could do stacks at a time if you wanted to. Remember, the andesite funnels only put out one at a time onto the belt, which is good for kind of limiting the flow of everything. And it's still making, because this thing holds quite a bit inside of it. I say quite a bit. It probably holds enough for 8 recipes, roughly, of this thing. And there you go. That is the mechanical mixture. You will use this for other items and other things. We needed it mainly to get brass, because in the brass stage, this stuff right here, we are going to need to use it to make further better things. All of these andesite things, there's a brass variant of it. And the brass variant of it allows you to filter items in and out, which we're going to need. It also allows us to make a lot of things, like the mechanical arm, to be able to feed this and right there and whatnot. So it's going to work good. I don't know if you guys want me to show you how to build a farm with what we got so far. We have to do a couple of the things. We have to cover the mechanical harvester next, and I can show you how to make a farm, which is, well, actually, yeah, we can do that. We can do that. That might be a thing. Now that we've got brass, we've got the door opened up to a whole lot of things, and I think that's what we'll do. We'll probably work on making a farm out of this. A kelp farm would be the obvious first thing, because you're going to need lots of kelp, and you're going to want to automate the kelp, right? And with the brass, we have this ability to do this. So guys, thanks for watching. I hope that clears up a little bit about the mechanical mixer for you and explains how it works, what to do with it, how to automate it. Again, I went through this very fast. Pause the video wherever you need to, kind of take a close look at this. It should be pretty simple to build. I mean, we built basically the same thing over here, only a little different. This is a lot simpler thing, but you should be able to see this quite well. Should be able to put this together on your own. And with what we've shown you with the water wheels for power, the belts we made, all of those kind of things, you should be able by this point to be able to do this. The toughest part of this whole thing is going to the nether, finding a blaze, and clicking it blaze burner in hand, clicking it on a blaze and catching it. You might want to, you know the drill. You need the nether for the nether rack anyway, so you got to run to the nether, get that, then find a fortress, find a blaze, click him, get him in there. And you're going to want to get several of these if you can, because when we get to the boiler section of this, we're going to want probably about 9 of these blaze burners. So if you get more than one, that's good. Matter of fact, you don't even have to fight the blaze, because you just capture them and they're done. They don't hurt you no more. So works out really well. But guys, hit a like. Don't forget to hit like if you liked it. Hit the subscribe and the notification bell should you want to see more of these. Thanks for watching. I am Old Man Shorty. I am out. See you. Bye.